How do you make a medical school list that gives you the best chances of acceptance into medical school? Hey, BeMo Nation, welcome to another episode of One Question Podcast. We have absolutely nothing to sell you, just pure content. And what we're going to do is we're going to share during these episodes our strategies and tips that we learn during our private consultation sessions. And we want to share these because we want to make sure everyone has equal access to education. In case you've never watched one of these, we don't do anything fancy. There is no fancy visuals. There is no fancy sound effects. There is no fancy music, just pure content. And we have exactly 10 minutes to tackle a hot topic in admissions every week. And as I mentioned at the beginning, today we're going to discuss how to make a medical school list that maximizes your chances of acceptance. So with that, we're going to start our timer. So here's our time. So there we go on my phone. We just started 10 minutes counting down. So first of all, my name is Behrouz Moemeni. I'm the CEO and founder here at BeMo, and I'm joined with Meng Yang, who is one of our senior admission experts. Meng, why don't you tell us what are the first, let's first talk about the most important factors that one needs to consider before even going into choosing a school list.
Factors to consider before choosing a school list. Well, there's a lot, as you can imagine. There's a lot of schools out there. So a lot of different factors will matter. One of the things I think a lot of people forget to think about is location. And that's something you can start thinking about before, during the whole process of selecting your medical schools. And then even afterwards, when you start getting acceptances at the very end, that's still something that you want to be thinking about. Location is important because it can, number one, determine whether you have an advantage at a school. It's also important because it determines your cost of living as well as your tuition costs. So it can determine, you know, how stable financially you'll be in the process of applying and going to medical school. So a lot of factors could go into it. That's one of the big ones that I think people should pay attention to before they even start considering their coming up with their list.
I think that makes perfect sense. And you know what? I'm going to step a little back, further back even, is why is it even important to be strategic about the school list? And it's important for a couple of reasons. And then Meng, if you have some other thoughts, you could also share as well. One of the things I think is that, one, cost. The more schools you add, the more you got to pay. Yeah. It's, you know, people forget medical school itself is not free. Neither is its application process. Two, time, which I think is even more important than money in that sense, because the more schools you choose, the more your limited attention is going to be divided amongst all these different applications that you have to fill out. Mm-hmm. The other thing is there is an element, unfortunately, there still exists an element of luck in the admissions process. Are you the first person that the admission officer is, you know, reviewing on that day, or are you the last? So you want to make sure that you've applied to sufficient number of schools that it makes sense. So those are the things that I think I would consider. And then we're going to go into tell you how to do this. Anything else of why, essentially why this is so important to choose very strategically the schools before actually going through the process, Meng?
Well, I'll just extend on one of the points you brought up, which is the limited amount of time that you have to devote to your applications. To extend that, you know, a lot of students think, well, I just have to do the primary once, right? Like if you're applying to US schools, Canadian schools is a slightly different story, but for those applying to US schools, if you're applying a primary, yes, it's just once that you create a personal statement, that you create your activities list. However, you have to think about secondaries, right? The secondaries takes a lot of time. There's a different set of questions for each school. The more schools you apply to, the more secondaries you have to do. And there's a limited amount of time that you have to get those into the schools to have a good chance at being considered for interviews. For Canadian schools, obviously, you know, for Ontario schools, it's one application. However, each school will have its own separate component, separate essay questions that you have to complete. And then for anything outside of Ontario, obviously each different school is a different application. So definitely something very important to think about. And the more time and energy you can devote to each application, the better its quality and the better chances you will have. So you're essentially trying to balance a lot of different constraints to come up with the optimal number of schools.
Exactly. And okay, so now let's get into it. And this is so important to choose the right list of medical schools, because if you choose it right, you're gonna significantly increase your chances of acceptance. One of the things you don't want to do is, hey, I have unlimited amount of time for whatever reason that is, which is probably impossible, and I want to apply to every school there is to maximize my chances. No, that's not going to maximize your chances. You maximize your chances by applying to the schools that actually make sense. So how do you do this? You look at the schools, and first of all, eliminate any school you're not eligible to apply based on the prerequisite courses. Simple, very simple. A lot of people miss that, and they try to negotiate with schools. It's like, if I don't have this and that course, can I? No, they already told you, don't even ask them. They're gonna mark you as someone who doesn't follow instructions. So don't do that. Two, you want to make sure that you exceed the average, or I should say the median GPA and MCAT scores for the accepted group of applicants from previous year. This is usually published for each school, and you could find it one way or another. You should be able to find this. If you can't find it, contact the admission office well in advance. They may be able to provide that to you. This tells you that if consistently, and you shouldn't just look at one year, you should look at multiple years if you can. If consistently they're looking, they have a median average of, let's say, 3.8, and your GPA is 3.6, you may not necessarily want to choose that as one of your schools unless you just have no other choices. I would look at two things: is what is the range of acceptance and what is the median? So let's say you notice that people have been accepted anywhere from a 3.2 to a 3.8, and you're 3.6, so you're within that range. And the median is 3.6. So you're like, okay, I'm right at the median and I'm within that range. That looks good. Ideally, you want to be above the median. So you check off that criteria. You do the same thing for MCAT. And you could do that for science GPA and, you know, overall GPA. You could do that for your overall MCAT. You could do it for every section. So that would be the first thing I think I would do. Second is, what is their mission statement? If they have published statistics, what's the number of people who have military experience, research experience, clinical experience, and how is that tied into their mission statement? Do you have those activities and experiences that you would believe qualify you to also apply to that school? So that would be my second criteria. And I think this should give you, and then I'm gonna allow Meng to add any final thoughts. This should hopefully give you, ideally, I would like to, if it were me, apply from, 10 to 15 schools, I think is good. You go a little bit more than that, it gets a little bit too much. You go a little bit below that, you're gonna play your luck a little bit. Although I would actually go minimum possible. So if you have absolutely fantastic GPA and MCAT and you have all those experiences, I would only do 5 schools max, because of the, again, it would allow me time to perfect the applications. I don't have undivided attention. But if you're average and you're not sure, then you want to have a little bit more schools, but not too much that it will take away your time. Also, never choose schools where you don't meet their GPA or MCAT requirements, as we discussed, not the minimum requirement, whatever we just talked about, and or those where you don't have their necessary experiences or meeting their prerequisite courses. Because even if it makes your school list very small, it's not worth choosing schools where you're guaranteed you're going to get rejected. It's very demotivating, and you choose up your time, money, and energy. It's not worth it. Meng, any final thoughts?
I just want to say, when you do compare your own scores to those of the schools that you're considering, one thing to look at is if they have a strong regional preference, because sometimes the benchmarks that you're looking at could differ significantly for those who are applying from in the state or in the province.
Good point.
Compared to those who are applying out of state or out of province. So you kind of want to see what category you fall in and then use those specific scores as benchmarks. Also, you want to, sometimes schools will have a stronger emphasis on certain sections of the MCAT, for example. That's another thing you could consider. Maybe your overall MCAT score isn't strong, but that school has specifically stated that they are only looking at this section or that section, or they're placing an emphasis on this section or that section that you actually did quite well on despite the overall scores, right? So there's some small, there's nuances that you could, that could help you or maybe hurt you, and you want to be aware of those.
Very good point. I think that wraps it up for us. We still have 5 seconds left, so this was good. And with that, we'd like to thank everyone for either watching or listening to another episode of our One Question podcast. If you like this, give this a like, comment if you have any questions, subscribe so that you don't miss any future episodes. With that said, thanks so much, everyone, and we'll talk to you soon.